Hello and welcome to the show. Now, when I was putting together the top 10 racing games list and the shortlist and so on video for that, I realized I have never actually made a video on the original Test Drive Unlimited. So I decided it was time to change that, and after much faffing about trying to get my save profile to load, eventually we have got it all working. I also know one of my favourite pastimes when it comes back to looking at old games is seeing how I've modified my cars, because they generally look absolutely atrocious, or in this case, what I've decided to dress my character in. Oh dear. Apparently I didn't have very good taste whenever the last time I played this game was. Certainly not in clothing. Car-wise, however, is fantastic, because in the garage that I just happened to load up in, we have got a Saleen S7 twin turbo that I remember being an absolutely bonkers, monstrously silly fast car. I seem to remember being the go-to car, really, with this game. Even better, it's in bright orange. I played this game. This is one of the first 360 games I ever properly got into. And this was long before I ever had the orange and black paint job going on. So I've got the right colour for the Saleen. We've also got not one, but two Alfa Romeo 8Cs in here. Oh, I can't scroll the other way. There are two 8Cs, because one's not enough, apparently, for me. We also have a Maserati MC12. I quite like the MC12. You can't really go wrong with that. We have an Esprit V8. We also have the Shelby Daytona. What other car? There's the other Alfa Romeo 8C. We have an Audi RS4. So, yeah, not a bad garage, really, to load up in two. My quest for today, I've done 150 miles in that 8C. 57 in that, not very many in that. Not very many in the Daytona. That's disappointing. And 60 miles in the other 8C. Why have I got two? I've got two. Are they both? Is one a convertible? No, they're both just identical. Maybe you win one in an event somewhere, and that's why I have two. Anyway, I say my quest for the day. What we are going to do is we are going to head out, find one of my houses. Also, I didn't realize. Okay, I was just flicking through this list of cars. The Chrysler ME412. Is in the original Test Drive. I don't remember that car being in here, but apparently it was. And there are also motorbikes. We've got bikes I have no real idea about what they are. Apparently I have plenty of AMG Mercedes. We also have the Chevrolet crazy pickup truck. We might have to head over to this garage as well, because it looks like there's quite a lot of interestingness going on in, ooh, the GR1 concept. Ooh, we might have to go over to this place, Point Paradise. I was going to head over to wherever. Ooh, we have an XJ220 as well. Where is it gone? Somewhere around. There it is. The Volkswagen W12 Coupe. It's not in enough games, this vehicle. Not enough games at all. We're going to head over towards Loophole Haven of Peace. It's not going to be peaceful if I have a W12 Volkswagen thing to go and have some fun with. Sorry, my voice giving up a little bit. So that's the plan. We're going to head over that way, and if we can happen to find this Kahuka, I don't know if that's pronounced right. I apologize if it is. It probably not. If we can find this Point Paradise, we will, along the way, we will go there as well. And if there's missions and so on, I might stop off and get distracted. That tends to be the way. You set out with an aim on Test Drive, go to a car showroom, go to somewhere, and you find something else, or you see a mountain that you think, oh, I fancy climbing that. And that's generally how all sessions of Test Drive Unlimited, whether it be on one or two, that's how they end. Right, so, as you can see, all of the green dots on this map are houses that that I own. That one's got a Ducati 999R in it. That one is empty. I have no cars in there. That will not do. If we happen to spot a car showroom along the way, we might go. That's actually not too bad of a drive over towards my Volkswagen W12 place. Where is the other? Where's the house then with some more, some more excitement? I don't think there was a yacht to buy in this one. I seem to remember the yacht on Test Drive Unlimited 2 was quite. Not that I ever. I say I never owned one. I technically did. I don't have the best luck when it comes to save files. My Test Drive Unlimited one got corrupted as well. I had to restart. At one point, I did have a yacht on Unlimited 2, but that very quickly changed. Are we going to? Yeah, when I restarted it, I thought I'd save the money and spend it on other cars. So, yeah, Unlimited 2, I always found was a little bit tight with money. Oh, well, bloody hell. Okay, we'll probably teleport over at the end to go investigate that one. We'll go for a drive over towards this one here up in the kind of will. Oh, that looks like a fun road. That looks like a lot of fun road to take on if we don't get lost along the way. Let's see. How quickly do we reckon we can get get across? Hello, sat-nav. Right, it is apparently 14 miles. Let's get a replay. Hold on, replay camera. Let's get a camera into the right point. There's a funny noise going on from my car. That's fine. Yeah. At the next intersection. As I said, this is a game that I played an awful lot of when it came out. As you saw at the start, I'm like 74% of the way through it, I think. I did as much as I could until I think Forza 3 came out, possibly. It's around that sort of time, and then I got distracted with Forza and so on, and then Unlimited 2 came out and so on. And yeah, I kind of haven't played this for quite a while. Whoa, Celine is mental. Celine is mental. If I remember rightly, we can, I think, spin the wheels all... No, we're not quite spinning the wheels up through third gear. We'll spin the wheels all the way through second gear. Oh, brakes! At some point, we might slow down. This thing is just stupid. Yeah, we do kind of spin the wheels up constantly. The fun with Test Drive was never doing the races. The races on Unlimited, they're okay. However, most of the entertainment comes from just simply driving around. Just simply going for an adventure. If you want to try and go, see that mountain ahead of us, I could try and climb it. It probably wouldn't end too well. Excuse me, I'm in a hurry. I'm in a hurry in a very, very quick car. But how fast we can get the Celine up to. Excuse me, Mr. Policeman. Don't mind the Celine suddenly doing 120. It'll probably be doing a lot more if you give it about 30 seconds. Bloody hell, it is quick. We're up to 200. We're going to slow down because otherwise we're going to go to space a little bit. Oh, the Celine is a monster. That's fine. That's fine. Only small bit of poo came out over that crest. Oh, we're going to murder a school bus if we're not careful. Oh, the grip in the Celine is pretty damn impressive. Oh, crap, we need this turning brakes. The handling physics on Test Drive Unlimited 1 are, I think, considerably better than that of 2. You don't... sorry, my voice is really giving up. It's typical. You don't have the kind of randomly, very, very loosely defined oversteer. That's the best way I can describe what goes on in Unlimited 2. Here, the cars are a lot more planted to the road. They don't snap loose on you for seemingly no reason. They don't get twitchy and try and murder you. And this is with everything, all this is turned off. Can I remember how to get through the menus? No, that's to do with the map. I still love that there is an option. One of my favourite things about the Test Drive games is that there is an option. I've got my map all... Hold on. Things there go. Driving aids are off on here. That's what I wanted to check. I've got my map in all askew with. There we go. No, we don't want to go up there. Spin it around. It's fine. We've got more than enough power to easily spin... the car around, launch our way down this motorway. Well, we're kind of halfway along our journey here. Yeah, the handling is very, very good on... I say very good on this game. It's not the greatest handling model I've ever driven with, but it is much easier to drive cars towards their limits, even crazy fast vehicles like this towards their limits. There's just more grip and there's a lot more consistency going on. Hello, don't mind me, that was only a small bump. Totally a small bump, that one. And the actual vehicle models, again, this is a relatively, certainly nowhere near some of the age of some of the games I've played, and it's a relatively old game. The vehicle models are very, very good. The world does look a little bit dated now. You've got to bear in mind the size of the map that is going on here. It's absolutely huge. It is a massive playground to go and exploring. And yes, Unlimited 2 was a little bit more detailed and does look a bit better and so on. But this was still a massive, massive playground when this game first came out. There wasn't many driving games that have as bigger a map. I mean, yeah, okay, Fuel has a stupidly large map, but I always find Fuel is a little bit of a... It's so big, I kind of get a bit lost in it and not as interested. Whereas Test Drive has certainly the Hawaii map. The Ibiza in 2 is a little bit on the smaller side. But the Hawaii map is just excellent to go and explore. There's plenty of incredible mountain roads to go and find and to race down. And that's where it's always excelled, is as an explorey thing. Yeah, we haven't got the car. Whoopsie-daisy, we've... We've found another use for a Selene. It is apparently a really good ramp. That's better damage on the civilian car I hit than there is on all of Gran Turismo put together. But yes, if we use this as a ramp car, that could be quite an entertainment, especially when you're doing, well, 100, 200 miles an hour in a very, very short space of time. I do remember the police being absolutely useless on this game. Oh, okay, we suddenly lost the back end. That's the first time we've actually had a even vaguely oversteery moment in a car this powerful. And that's across these bumps and these crests as I am trying to now be a little bit on the too eager side. Oh god, more on the too eager side. There we go. Uh-oh. Oh no, there wasn't. Oh, disappointing. There wasn't the launch of the SUV this time around. Shall we try something silly? I'm up for trying something silly. Selene, let's see how you do off-road. Yes, 1,000 horsepower Selene is going to go exploring through the forest. Please don't get stuck. Please don't get stuck. We're going to try and go in a straight line here. I don't know quite. It says it's got 4 miles. That's the wrong one. I'll remember these controls. There we go. Can we get any more zoomed? No, not really any more zoomed in. It's fine. Nothing untoward is going on here. Okay, there's a little bit of dodgy textures going on. I don't quite know how we're going to get up that hill. I think we're going to use speed. We shall use speed and momentum. Speed and momentum to climb this hill, I think, is the way to go. Floor it. Floor it. No! Speed and momentum has failed me. How are we going up the hill backwards? I don't know what went on there. Weird things have happened. Really rather weird things have happened. I know it might technically have been quicker to follow the road where I'm supposed to go, but bugger it, this is more entertaining. I love that about Test Drive. Really, when I played this game, I don't know if there, I'm assuming there probably was open world games that really did just literally let you point your car at anything and drive before Test Drive. There probably was, but this was the first time that I'd ever played it. And with such a big playground as this, is very impressive. Needless to be Underground 2 is, you know, a fantastic game, great free roaming in that. But, you didn't quite have this much of an area to go exploring with. And, there's just something special about Test Drive allowing you to go and do all of this. Allowing you to just point the car at a mountain and go and have fun. Apparently the sat-nav thinks that this is a route. And I find that quite amusing because this definitely does not look like a road in any way, shape or form. And if you're not giving me a road, why on earth is it giving me corners that I'm supposed to be? I'm kind of curious as to why it wants me to go this particular way. At what speed? We're doing 60 miles an hour through here. I'm not sure you would want to be taking your Selene. There's a dip your there at 60 miles an hour down this surface. Is that a road I spy? That looks like some tarmac. We might have found it is. Oh, there's a crash barrier there. Oh, I remember the dastardly crash barriers. Well, yes, the game will let you fire your car in any which direction you please. If you want to get back on the road, you've got to try and be patient and find a gap in the crash barriers. That's not too bad. I certainly do remember when I've sort of fallen off a ravine somewhere or done something silly, you can have a lot of difficulty trying to get your car back onto the correct path. Right. Hello, Mr. Policeman Officer. We're going to go around that way. There we go. Nothing illegal happening here at all. Nope, I'm not bouncing my car off of the curbs, going very sideways and suddenly doing 120. Okay, that was slightly my fault. I really shouldn't have been overtaking that side. But there we go. It's, as far as the world goes, it's a little bit quiet in terms of AI traffic. Although, to be fair, we are out in the sticks here. I'm pretty sure this road only leads to my house as well, so not many people would be heading up this way. Again, 100. It just gets to like 150 so stupidly quick. It is as much fun to drive the Selene as I remember. I wonder what is thy car with the most mileage on. Yeah, I have a really, really awesomely long private road. I want the house as well, to be honest. Let's face it. Who doesn't want this mansion? One of the slight downsides with Unlimited, you can't wander around in first person like you could in the second game. They are still interiors to the houses. You can still go into the showrooms, but you can't kind of wander around in first person. Let's go and jump into our garage. Let's have a look around this nice shiny place. There is the Selene that we turned up in. We have a Skyline over here. We have an Aston Martin V8 Vantage. We have a Viper. Cannot go wrong with a good Viper. Ooh. Ooh. 4, we have a classic Maserati. I don't remember that being in this game. I assume that's probably... Do they have the wrecked cars to find around the island? I don't remember. They might just be unlocks. Because I mean, the Shelby Daytona, I know, was a wreck find in the second one. Maybe. I mean, it would kind of make sense. Oh, we have a Bond villain car. Is there machine guns as options? I hope there's machine guns as options and rockets and so on. That's the Volkswagen we came here to see. Well, while we are here, there's a Saturn Curve. That's an odd looking thing. A Gallardo Spider, which you can't go wrong with either. Yeah, I remember this being... So it's just such an odd car, and a car that I was always interested to have in this game. As you can see, I haven't driven a huge amount of miles in the vehicle. Let's go and take the Volkswagen for a spin. It looks fantastic, actually. I do like the W12 concept-y thing. We will go and try and do a mission. Possibly. I don't love the interior quite so much. It is on the rather... It's very blue. It's very blue inside the car. I think I can paint the outside. No, wrong one. What was? No, I don't want the driving aid. Go away. Is it up? There we go. Kind of windows? Right, which way? Up on the D-pad. Yeah, I guess kind of got... Oh, wait, are they only... Oh, that's cool. Even with like the concept cars, I've actually got the windows working how the windows should be working. That's pretty neat. And then you've got a lot of sky above you. And I love the detail of looking around these cars in this game. Well, that is, yeah, again, another huge strength of Test Drive. Of course, yeah, Unlimited 2 is a better looking game. Bloody hell, this car is a lot noisier than the Celine. That much is for sure. For some reason, my camera hasn't recentered itself properly, but there we go. Yeah, that's a lot of W12 noise going on from the Volkswagen. Well, seeing as there is a chap just around the corner, shall we go and have a race with Howard? Howard, unless Howard is driving like a monster car, in which case, then we will probably not. Or he's like on a superbike or something. Or whoever I get to first, it might be Harvey. It is Harvey. Harvey has a Maserati convertible. That's certainly not a bad car. I think I can probably take him in the Volkswagen, though. Harvey, come back here. We need someone to race around these awesome, awesome mountain roads. And I think I might be able to beat you. Unless it... I don't even think a crazily modified one of them would be able to keep up with me. Waiting for a reply. He does fancy a race. Fantastic. Let's go and... Ooh, do we get to pick a... Oh, that's cool. I forgot about this. We get to pick our own race route. So, where would we like to head? We got to go for... Alright, so we've got to be far enough away for it to be a finish point. Unfortunately, we can't zoom out, which is a little bit of a shame. I'm fairly sure there was a creating your own race routes in 2. It's been a while. Yeah, okay, so we've got D-Class Maserati Spider to try and race against. I've lost where we are. It's a little bit of a bugger not being able to zoom out, I will be honest. Is that my house? Could we race back to my house? That'd be a little bit boring. We've already done that road. Somewhere over, and unfortunately it doesn't let me just put the random point, you know, in the middle of, well, here. Yes, I want to race to the waterfall, please. I mean, we can go there. It's just we're not going to actually be racing to the physical waterfall. Confirm this route. Yeah, bugger it. You know what? We'll go for it. Oh, okay, countdown is a go. Is that just it setting up the race? Is it loading what, I was going to say, hopefully that's not started the race. Is this the way the game's giving giving the Maserati a chance? It's going to give him a nice head start. Right. Oh, get our Volkswagen fired up. And we will get underway. I didn't realise it wasn't going to put me in gear. Maserati has got off to a pretty impressive start. Not that it's really going to matter a huge amount. Oh, that was a... That was a vehicle. I don't know if we put the Maserati in the SUV or quite where he went. He's still behind me, somewhere over there. Weave our way through all of this traffic. That's typical I say about there not being a huge amount of traffic, and now I seem to find all of it on this small country road. Well, relatively small country road. There we go. We're through the gaps and unleashing all of that Volkswagen power. Careful, that's an SUV. We haven't got the launch module installed. We need launch module. Was that in the distance? I think a front bumper went spinning off of someone's car. Hopefully not mine. There will Okay, pickup started moving. Didn't expect that one. Well, kind of didn't hope that it wasn't going to. And yeah, hoping wasn't the best of things. I've lost complete sight of the car I am racing. Where is he? Oh, is he all the way back there? Oh, he's had a crash. That makes my life 10 times easier. Can we just open up the taps on the Volkswagen and see what we can do in terms of straight line speed? Maybe not when there's a car there. And then there's a van. And then there's a car changing lane. Bloody cars doing their own thing. You could be a lot more respectful of a race that is currently going on between two, well, one concept and one relatively, I was going to say two ludicrously expensive cars. I don't even know what the value of this thing would be. Almost over the van, or almost into the van, more than over the van. Slow down, that's a tree. Well, I guess if it all goes wrong, we can use the tree to slow us down. That's surprisingly controlled for, well, guesswork at that moment in time. Forgot about these vicious crests everywhere. This Volkswagen has spent more time in the air, I think, than it has on the ground. Okay, no, we're fine. This is their running. They should be using these rather than the polos of, I think it's polos they run in, or they have run in the WRC, isn't it? They should have been using these, though. These are apparently very, very good at dealing with jumps. Not very good with me driving them, however. Oh, thank you, AI. I'm actually quite impressed. I had never really paid a huge amount of attention to the way the AI cars interact with you, but they actually do a pretty good job on the most part of diving out of your way. Oh, big sideways moment to finish. Totally meant to do that. I got no money. No money for that at all. Probably because I was in a way too fast for a car. But there we go. Yeah, that's the Volkswagen. I like it. I really, really like it. Shall we go and see what... Do we have any missions nearby? There's a challenge. Okay, so the race is for whatever kind of stuff. I think actually an online race, which won't work because there are no servers anymore. We have missions where we have to pick up people and deliver them. There's mission restriction vehicle with two seats. So I guess, yeah, so there's a hitchhiker mission. I think there are two kind of hitchhiker missions. There is like a convoy, like a delivery missions, and some other stuff around the place. As you can see, you know, there's plenty of stuff to be doing. I think I've completed all of these, because I think you need to complete all of them to unlock various... vehicles, various special vehicles like the concept cars, etc. We will 180 miles an hour in traffic. Yeah, let's go give it a try, shall we? Can we do 180 miles an hour heavy traffic? It'd be easier in the Saline, but we're going to give it a go in the Volkswagen, see if I am a good enough driver to manage this one. I've done it before, but we've got all sorts of bars telling me stuff. Make sure the car is fired up. Right, so I'm guessing if we make too many crashes, we're going to empty bar on the left, and that will fail me. You also forgot to say that this was 180 miles an hour in heavy traffic and a really, really, really bumpy road. Like, really bumpy road. Bloody trucks. This might be the mission that's really, really good for grinding out money. If you get the Saline or the Enzo, you'll get it completed in a matter of seconds, and then that's 70 grand, and then you can just keep doing it again and again and again. And I've murdered the Volkswagen slightly. We got really close. I don't actually dare take my eyes off the screen long enough to see how fast we are going. We're getting close, though, in our W12. Don't know where the road's going. Made a mistake. Come on. Beautiful tarmac. Thank you. Right. Let's try and actually stay on the motorway here at some point. If we could just have a nice enough straight bit that's not got bloody jumps in. We keep getting about 140 and then I have to brake. This might be... Now this is a bit of road I've never driven on. Judging by the map, the colour the road is going. Oh, come on, we're 150. I'm going to lose the back end if we're not careful. Come on, Volkswagen. We can do it. Hey, that's 181 miles an hour. Do we have to keep it above the speed for a certain amount of time? I don't actually know. We definitely hit 181. Maybe it wasn't enough. Ah, okay, so the speed on the... There we go. The speed is like 190 and I'm doing two... What? There's like a 4 mile an hour difference going on there. Either way, I'm going to complete it. Final score, 199.92, apparently. My record is 209. I feel like I could go a lot faster than that. I guess I probably just got lazy and finished the thing as soon as I did it. Yeah, great easy way to grind out money. And that's one of the things I didn't like so much about Unlimited 2. While it gave you a lot more features, a lot more cars and more to explore, I love that the first person free roaming in the various areas, money was always such an arse to get. And you know, you can't blame microtransactions for that, there weren't in Unlimited 2, but it was just a difficult thing to earn money in. So when you got to the end of the game, if you wanted to own or collect various cars, it was just a faff. Whereas on here, a lot easier to come by. Right, we're going to finish off. As much fun as it has been, that's not the button to get to the map, as much fun as it has been in the Volkswagen, shall we go and have a look at my other garage? All the way up in the top over here, because I think this is the one with all the other exciting cars. Was it Chevrolet? I can't even remember where I was going to go. Oh, let's go get the SSR out while we're up here. Because I like wacky cars. I like wacky cars, and the SSR is, very, very much that. Also, it very much reminds me of Midtown Madness 3. That was the first place I ever saw the SSR. Again, we've got both of the Bond cars. That needs to be in silver, but never mind. Oh, that's what we came here to look for. The Shelby GR1 concept. There is another one, the Shelby Cobra concept. Also, but I haven't unlocked that. I don't know how we get that. DB9 convertible. We've got our convertible section over here, apparently. That's invisible. Ah, there it is. These damn cloaking... You put the cloaking device on the wrong car. It should be on the Vanquish, not on the Mercedes. There's another AMG over there. Apparently I liked the 430. Okay, could have been prizes for stuff. Oh, now you put it on a wrong Aston Martin as well. There we go. Well, I was going to get the SSR. It is a great thing to have in the game. We'll go and grab this, though, instead, because it was 605 horsepower. Yes, please, I would like to take it for a spin. And I can't think, I might be wrong, can't think of another game that I've seen this GR1 concept on. Trying to rack my brains where it might be on like the Ford racing games. I've never played any of them, so it might be on one of them. If it isn't, I don't know where you would find it. Might just pull out on somebody, but never mind. It's great to have all of these slightly obscure vehicles. I mean, there's all the classics, you know, all the vehicles you would expect, all the supercars of the day and hypercars and the odd classic vehicle here and there, but just having some obscure concepts is nice. We're going to finish off by heading towards a garage, perhaps. There's a European Classics. Unfortunately, I would head over there, but that's going to be a Mura and an E-Type. I say unfortunately. Mura and E-Type. Glorious, glorious cars. I was just hoping for more selection than just two. What have we got over here? Okay, I like the sound of British independence. What we're going to do is we're going to GPS target that, and I'm just going to teleport myself somewhere around about here. Are we gonna have a nice little coast drive to get us to our destination? 3 miles. Okay, we're gonna set ourselves a mini challenge. Within these 3 miles, we're gonna try and get our concept car. Hello, Phil, teleporting in with your spiker. We're gonna try and crack 200 miles an hour. Might be a bit of a tall order. I'm gonna give it a damn good shot though. I'm not quite sure what's going on with the dials in this car, but never mind. Oh, Jesus. We may have murdered that. That is also the most pathetic horn for such an impressive car. It's useless. Okay, that would definitely need work if this was to become a real car. You can't have that on a super muscle car, really, is what this is. I guess closest to, at least. Anyway, we might be almost about to hit our target if the policeman doesn't turn into us. Keep going. I don't know what the present means. I assume that's... we hit 200. I had to brake. Had to brake really quite quickly. We did get 200, so I completed my little mini challenge. I also like that this game, when you look behind, if you're in cockpit view, it actually looks behind through the car as if you were looking behind you, which a lot of games at this sort of time would cop out of loading or rendering, you know, the actual full car interior. Even if they had cockpit view, a lot of times you press look behind and it would just be sort of on the boot looking backwards. So pretty neat all around. This is handling a lot better than I was expecting it to. I was expecting it to be quite a leery, oversteery, silly vehicle. It isn't. It's actually got quite a lot of grip. Oh, change direction. Thank you, van, for manically swerving out of the way. That would have been much appreciated. Oh, that one there. Ugh, I was busy looking up at the signs. That one swerved and I didn't quite move myself in time. Yeah, you can still crash. I found the garage. We are arriving at the garage in a, well, probably a cloud of broken car smoke. It's Farbound. Hold on a second. I don't recognise that name. I think I said Farbound. Ooh. Well, we have new cars to go and explore. It's very, very shiny, that Ford concept. Chrome was apparently in when they designed that one. Oh, that... I don't remember the F1 GTR being here. That's exciting. Ascari KZ1. One of the few places you'll find Ascari is in test drive. Forza 4 had one Ascari, and that's about it. Farbound supercharged GTS prototype. Never seen it before. Well, I probably have when playing this. Outside of here, never seen it anywhere. Noble M12 and a Noble M14. What's the other Noble? Is that just another M12 over there? Yeah, pretty much. I like how they have like filler cars around the garage. Well, this is quite a nice showroom. 1.5 million for the F1 GTR. Yeah, I mean, I could go for that. That's... Yeah, that's a pretty good... Oh, they've got two! They've got two F1 GTRs in here! I can spy that other one. Again, it's a shame you can't look around, but there is definitely a second one in this showroom. Bloody hell. That's, if we go to buy... Ah, then we've got all of the customization options. I want the orange one! I want the orange one. You've got it next to it. I don't know if you're going to go across to have a look at it. No, we're not. Do we have... It might be because the McLaren F1 can't be... The F1 GTR can't be customized. Does Test Drive Unlimited 1 have options for custom interiors? Ooh, that's a very bright red. Let's have a look. Ah, they do! That's cool. McLaren F1, you can't change. However, yeah, I just like all of the neat little touches on this game. It is very, very cool. Right. Yes, I want this car. I don't remember ever seeing or noticing this particularly around the place, but I want one. You know, we're just going to wander into a showroom and go away with an F1 GTR. As you do. Look at that. Well, that's an interesting camera angle. That's kind of more window than, well, anything. It's a menacing sight, isn't it? Front of the F1. I don't know what we've done with the... Where has my shiny Ford gone? I mean, I like this. If you want to keep the shiny Ford, I guess it's kind of an okay swap, though I would still quite like to keep the shiny Ford around. Well, there we go. Bit of an explore through the world of Test Drive Unlimited. Yeah, it is as entertaining as it always has been, just for somewhere to go and have a drive, a great selection of cars and some obscure concepts added in to the mix. Some crazy fast vehicles. Like this very, very noisy McLaren, and a slightly better handling model than the second game, although perhaps slightly less to do, and, you know, less detailed in places. However, as a game to go drive on, it is a little bit better on the handling. There is, Test Drive Unlimited, the rights to it have been bought relatively recently, so there is hope that we may see an Unlimited 3 at some point in the future, quite when, who knows. However, get the exploring aspects right, you know, the first-person exploring of showrooms and the huge maps right, with the complete and utter freedom to go wherever you want, and a very good handling model. Yeah, it could be a driving game to beat if they can nail absolutely everything. However, that is going to be it from me. Thank you very much for watching, and until next time, don't quite know how we moved because I wasn't in gear, but goodbye.